started off looking at technology and seeing was there a way that you could make the process of media monitoring better than it had been. And around the end of 2001, beginning of 2002, I felt that there was a proposition there that could make commercial sense. So we thought of a name, Media Market, and we decided to incorporate a company. We moved here in 2003, staff numbers were beginning to grow. I think we had about 10 staff at that point, and it became obvious that IT was the key driver of the business. We then decided that we were going to develop our own IT platform to customise it for clients and to be able to add features to the system as clients wanted. And I know you might every tomorrow. In 2004, saw us utilise our resources in software development. We released one of a media analysis software package, and all the while clients were growing and the market was becoming more technology friendly. In 2005, I'd say, was maybe a year when the business hit maturity, and it was a year when I think the clients very much accepted that this was the way forward. We also launched internet monitoring in 2006, and clients wanted to be able to get content from all sources, broadcast, press, internet, and all delivered to the same platform.
We thought we were swinging it a bit with the panel. Jesus, lad, you've taken it to an art form.
In 2007, the business was ticking along very nicely. By that stage, we were up to 50 staff. Client base had grown to in excess of 700 clients. We opened an office in Northern Ireland in Belfast. We developed this Media One platform. We were funded by Enterprise Ireland to develop it, and a lot of work went into it. And I think that was a key milestone for the business. I don't wanna stand still. I just wanna free will. Look!
actually not going to put this down. I'm going to hang on to it.
In 2008, we became part of a larger group, Taylor Nelson Softwares, TNS, a major media research company, and we became part of a global network.
This is solely a personal decision. I know in my heart of hearts that I've done no wrong and wronged no one.
That out of many, we are one. That while we breathe, we hope. And where we are met with cynicism and doubt, and those who tell us that we can't, we will respond with that timeless creed that sums up the spirit of a people. Yes, we can.
2009, what can I say? That was when the year the recession hit, which in a way was a good thing. It allowed us to refocus on clients and become more client-centric.
I've been roaming around, always looking down at all I've...
Richard Dunn lost out. Oh, Ari! Oh, it's in the net! It's a goal!
I think the Irish players are appealing for a handball here.
Who have we got here?
We're twins. I'm Edward. I'm John, and we're 17, and we're from Dublin.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
So help you God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. President.
The year when I handed over to Dan Halliwell.
2010 was a significant year. TNS Media Market became Kantar Media. Also in 2010, we launched our social media monitoring service to complement our internet monitoring service, and it's proved extremely popular. In 2011 also saw us embark on producing a journalist contact database, which we felt would complement our services and allow our clients to draw more data from us. 2011 also saw us launch Kantar Sport, which again was available in other countries within the Kantar group. And beyond will see us launching an ad vouching service for advertising agencies in the Irish market, and we'll also expand our services into ad expenditure.
I think the future for Kantar Media is very bright. I think there's a great team in place in both the Dublin and Belfast office.
The future of the business is no different to when we started. Our services will still be centred around our clients and empowering them with the data that we can provide and the insight that we can put on top of that to ensure they make the right decisions around their PR and advertising functions.